Welcome back to another video. I definitely need a haircut, but we're not here to talk about fashion today. Today we're taking a look at 6 gravel bikes under $2,000. I thought this was a mountain biking channel. Yes it is, but there was a time not so long ago that I was a misguided young man who took a liking to road biking. Before I bought my YT Jeffsy, I was actually looking at gravel bikes for a less radical transition into off-road riding. So whether you're a road biker looking to venture off-road, or a mountain biker wanting more cardio, or to challenge yourself on your local trails, I've got 6 affordable gravel bikes worth considering. Why 6, you may ask? I decided to break this up into 2 categories, with 3 bikes between the $1,500 and $2,000 price range, and then 3 bikes under $1,500. That way we have 2 budgets in 1 video, so you can determine if you want to spend more and get a little more, or go with a more budget option. All the pricing in this video was based off of full retail pricing. This list was actually very difficult to put together because there are a ton of great options under $2,000. So if there's a bike you like that isn't on this list, that doesn't mean it's a bad bike. These are just 6 bikes that I found to offer good value. That's enough disclaimers, let's go ahead and jump in with our 3 more expensive options. The Nukeproof Digger Comp. Coming in at $1,600, this bike borrows more from the MTB side of things, which makes sense as Nukeproof doesn't offer any road bikes. It features an aluminum frame with a carbon fork, 1x11 Shimano GRX gravel-specific drivetrain, hydraulic disc brakes, through axles, 650B Road Plus tubeless wheels and tires, along with internal cable routing for a dropper post. It's also compatible with 700C wheels and offers plenty of bosses for mounting racks and fenders. Everything about this bike screams pure fun. While gravel bikes are designed to go on-road and off-road, I'm willing to bet this bike would be a lot more fun off-road. Just take a look at Nukeproof's marketing videos for this bike. This bike is my personal favorite on the list, but we still have 5 other great options to take a look at. The Ragley Trig Adventure. Another gravel bike built by a mountain bike company, also sitting at $1,600. The frame is chromoly steel with a carbon fork, SRAM Apex 1x11 drivetrain, hydraulic disc brakes, through axles, 650B tubeless wheels, tires, and external cable routing. This bike is also compatible with 700C wheels and offers mounting bosses. The Ragley also offers the longest reach and slackest head angle on this list, hinting at its mountain biking lineage. This bike and the Nukeproof Digger are both very similar, with the biggest difference of course being the frame material. The only thing that the Nukeproof has over this bike is the internal cable routing for a dropper post if you choose to add one later on. This is the only steel framed bike on this list, so if you do like steel frames, this is the bike for you. Next up is the Ribble CGR-AL. This is a bike brand I discovered through my viewers' comments on my budget hardtail list video, and I'm glad you guys brought Ribble to my attention. The CGR, the cross, gravel, and road, that's what that stands for, is actually offered in 4 different frame materials. You can get it either in aluminum, steel, carbon, or titanium, and they even offer an e-bike version. That is insane. I don't know any other company that has one model in 4 different frame materials, but due to the budget, we will be focusing on the aluminum version. With several different build kits available, I was most drawn to the gravel build for $1,663. This build essentially offers everything the last 2 bikes had, but what's unique is Ribble lets you customize every single component. With their online bike builder, you can select your wheel size, group set, tires, brakes, handlebars, etc., etc. You can customize literally everything so you can get the perfect bike build for you. You can even custom paint your build. That is going to be an extra cost, but if you want a one-of-a-kind bike, you can do it. The geometry on this bike isn't as long or slack as the previous 2 mentioned. It's a little bit more traditional geometry, but with the customization potential, you can truly build the perfect bike for your needs. Those are the 3 bikes if you're more interested in mid-level components and willing to spend over $1,500. So let's go ahead and turn our attention to the 3 bikes under $1,500. But first, a surprise appearance from the Ribble CGR. Technically, I guess there's 7 bikes on this list now, but the Ribble CGR Sport is their entry-level build at $1,040, and it's a pretty great value. You get a 2x10 Shimano drivetrain, mechanical disc brakes, and some other cheap parts, but it's a very competitive price with the other three bikes we're about to discuss. Alright, enough about Ribble, so let's get to the three other bikes I picked under $1,500. The Marin Gestalt X10. I think it's Gestalt. Every list I've done, there's at least one bike I can't pronounce. I think it's Gestalt. I'm gonna go with that. Coming in at $1,300, this is another bike more inspired by mountain bikes than road bikes. Another aluminum frame with carbon fork, this bike has a SRAM Apex 1x10 drivetrain with Tektro mechanical disc brakes, tubeless ready 700C wheels and tires, and even dropper post routing. With clearance for 650B wheels, along with bosses for mounting racks and fenders, this bike does offer a lot at $1,300. The biggest sacrifice on this bike is the mechanical disc brakes, but it's very unlikely you'll find a bike with hydraulic brakes at this price point. If you're willing to step up to the next level and drop $2,200, the Gestalt X11 gives you an 11-speed drivetrain, hydraulic brakes, and even a dropper post, but for most riders, the X10 is perfectly sufficient. Next is the GT Grade Elite. At only $1,000, this bike is listed as an Enduroad, which is quite possibly the best marketing term ever for gravel bikes. Once again, aluminum frame with carbon fork, the Grade Elite uses a 2x8 Shimano Claris drivetrain, Tektro mechanical disc brakes, and tubeless ready wheels and tires with through axles. I'm also pretty sure this bike offers the most mounting points on this list, so it is a great option for touring or bikepacking. The floating seat stay triple triangle design has also received a good amount of praise for offering a little bit of flex in the rear of the bike. This bike is really cool for $1,000, and they even got skills with Phil in the marketing, so that is a big bonus. I really don't have anything else to say about this bike, but it seems like a really solid choice at $1,000. Last and certainly least in terms of pricing is the Felt Brome 60, coming in at $949. Felt has never really caught my attention as a bike manufacturer, but in researching this video, I found this particular bike to be a good offering at this price point. Aluminum frame, carbon fork, tubeless ready wheels and tires, and through axles are all nice features for a sub $1,000 bike. 2x8 Shimano Claris and Sora mixed group set and Tektro mechanical disc brakes round off this entry-level gravel bike. This bike also features larger tire clearance and a slacker head angle than the GT, so this may actually be the more relaxed and comfortable ride for casual cyclists. There you have it. Those are six affordable gravel bikes that will get you out exploring roads and trails. Like I said earlier, there are a ton of great options under $2,000, and if I were to feature all of them, this video would easily be an hour long. These are just the six that stuck out to me, and I would not hesitate to recommend any of them. If you are in the market for a new bike, make sure you do your research, compare specs and geometry figures between bikes, go demo as many bikes as you can, and that way you can find the perfect bike for you. What do you think of gravel bikes? Are they here to stay, or are they just another cycling fad? Let me know down in the comments below. Personally, I think they're really cool. To me, they're basically retro mountain bikes with modern features and drop bars. That's just my opinion. Feel free to jump in here and correct me. I hope you enjoyed this video or found it useful if you are shopping for a new bike. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends who may be in the market for a new bike. Also, please consider subscribing if you aren't already. Thank you so much for watching, and until next week, stay rowdy within reason.